Hey guys, welcome to a new flight in Microsoft Flight Simulator X. From now on, I will continue to upload every month videos in English of one new flight, and I will split every flight in several videos. So today we will fly with a Boeing 737-800 of Alaska Airlines. And with this aircraft, we will fly from San Diego to the base airport of Alaska Airlines, so to the airport Seattle-Tacoma. The flight distance of our flight today will be about 940 nautical miles, and the flight time of this flight is about 2.5 hours. So, and now I would say we can go into the cockpit of the Boeing 737 and start preparing this aircraft for our flight today. At the moment, the 737 is at cold and dark state, so first we need to start with the electrical power up to get some electricity here on board. So, there the first step is to close the battery switch guard, which is located in the overhead panel. We have it right here. There it is. This one needs to be closed, and now the batteries are switched on and we have already some current here, some electricity on board, but not enough to use all systems of the aircraft. So the next step is to connect the ground power unit to have enough current here on board to use all systems of the aircraft. So in order to connect the ground power unit, we need to go to the menu here to FS Actions and then to Ground Connections. We can clear this message here, and here you can see we can connect the ground power, which we will connect now, and then we can also connect the air conditioning unit. So, but although we connected the ground power already, we do not use the current which is provided by the ground power, but to use the current which is provided by the ground power, we also need to move this switch into position on, and now we do not use the current which is provided by the batteries, now we use the current which is provided by the ground power, which is here next to the aircraft. There it is, there's the ground power unit, the GPU, the external power, and here on this side of the aircraft there is the air conditioning unit. So, and the last step, the last point of the electrical power up is to set the position lights switch to steady, so to this side, and later on when we are close to takeoff, we will move this switch to the other side to strobe and steady. Now there are the red and green light on the wings are turned on, and also the white light here in the back of the wing. So now we are completed with the electrical power up. We have some electricity here on board, enough to use all of the systems of the aircraft. And the next step then is to now request the catering services and also the boarding. I use GSX, the add-on ground services X, therefore. So let's open the menu of GSX, and then we can request the catering services. So, and we also need to select the handling operator. I don't know which one of these is the handling operator here at San Diego, but I will choose now ATS, Airport Terminal Services. Maybe it's Southwest Airlines, or both are handling operator here at San Diego. I don't know, but it doesn't matter which one we choose. So, and here the belt loaders already drive towards the aircraft, but they will first start to move up this one here when the baggage of the passengers are here brought to the aircraft by these two trucks here. They are now getting to the terminal or somewhere else to fetch the baggage of our passengers for this flight today. And the catering services should be on their way towards the aircraft. There's another aircraft taxiing towards the runway. There's one taking off, and there are the catering services coming towards our aircraft, and we need to open both doors here on the right side so that they can put all the foods and drinks on board. So in order to do this, we need to go to doors, and here we can open the forward right and after right door, and we can also open on the left side the after door. The forward door is already opened, and we can also already open the forward and after cargo door so that the baggage of the passengers can be loaded into the belly of the aircraft afterwards when the catering is completed. But we can now already request boarding, but boarding will first start when the catering services are finished. So we can request boarding now, and there it says waiting for other services to complete. So first the catering services need to finish their work, then the baggage of the passengers will be loaded into the aircraft. So now we can go on with the pre-flight procedure, and there the first step is to move the IRS mode selectors here in the back of the overhead panel to nav. So first the left IRS mode selector and then the right IRS mode selector. And now we can do the CDU pre-flight. We can now type in all information. We can now put in all information that is needed for this flight into the airborne computer, into the FMC. So let's go into the FMC, and we can now go to all through all pages and type in all the necessary information for our flight today. So the catering vehicles are in position. We can have a look outside here of this window on the right side next to the first officer seat, and there you can see a man bringing all food and drinks here on board for this flight from San Diego to Seattle. So now let's start with the CDU pre-flight. We now need to enter the IRS position, therefore we copy the last position and set it here, put it in here to set IRS position. So now also PFD and ND are working because the aircraft is now located, and now we can type in the route. I already saved the waypoints and airways for our flight today by using a company route, so we only need to load the airways and waypoints for this flight here into the FMC, and we can do this by typing in the name or the code of the company route. And the company route is the following. So it begins with the ICAO code of Seattle, of the airport of Seattle. It's Kilo Sierra Alpha November. Then the ICAO code of the airport of Seattle follows, of the airport Seattle Tacoma. It's Kilo Sierra Echo Alpha. And then there need to be 2 0s and 1 1. So, and this comes in here to company route. And now all airways and waypoints for our flight today are loaded here into the board computer, into the airborne computer. And we can also type in our flight number for this flight today. It's Alaska Airlines 481, Alpha Sierra Alpha 481. It's also a flight number which Alaska Airlines uses in reality for this flight. And then we can now select our departure and arrival. So the SID for the departure, standard terminal, the SID and the standard terminal arrival route, star. Yeah. So and first we and therefore we need to so to know st- to know so that we know which runway we should take for takeoff. Oh, we can already close the right entry after. Looks like the catering services are nearly finished. So. Right entry after, we can close, and the forward entry we will also close soon, I think. Yeah, there we can close the right entry forward, and then boarding should start in just a few minutes. So in order to know which runway we should take for takeoff, we will now contact ground. But before we contact ground, we'll first listen to the ATIS to get the latest weather information here of the weather here at San Diego. Alright, so this was the weather information here for the airport San Diego, so we now can contact ground and request a direct departure, and they will probably tell us to depart at runway 09. Yeah, that is. Runway 09, where also the other aircrafts we saw a few minutes ago departed. So, we can now select the SID now. So we choose runway 09, which will be the runway we will depart here in San Diego, and the SID for our departure today is Lindsay 3 departure. We'll do Lindsay 3. We will use the SID Lindsay 3 departure. So and transition is this one, Sierra Lima, India. So now we have selected our departure for our standard instrument departure route here for San Diego Airport, and we can now select our standard terminal arrival route for the airport of Seattle. So due to the winds, due to the weather, oh, we need to open the left entry forward. Did I close it? No, it's opened. That's strange, but yeah, let's close it and then we can open it again. Then should everything should be all right. So now the entry is open. The passengers are boarding now, great, and the baggage should be loaded into the aircraft too. So, yeah, due to the weather and the wind in Seattle-Tacoma, at the airport Seattle-Tacoma, we will probably land on runway 34 left, and there we will do an ILS approach. So we select ILS 34 left, and the star we will use today for the approach at Seattle-Tacoma is Hawks 3.34 Bravo, this one here, and we need to select two transitions. On the left side here, the transition Bravo Tango Golf, and on the right side, the transition Sondra, Sierra Oscar November Delta Romeo. So, then we can also put this into our route, and now we can activate our route and execute everything. So, great, there now everything is fine, and we can go to the performance init page, but let's have a look outside. Yeah, there it is, there you can see the trucks are coming back to the aircraft now, with all the baggage of the passengers, and the belt loaders here are moving the baggage into the belly of the aircraft. Great. So they should be finished soon, and we will also be finished in a few minutes. So here we are now in the performance init, at the performance init page. We will first put in the zero fuel weight here. The reserves of our flight today are 6,500 lbs, so we type it in like this, and before we continue here, we first need to go to the menu page and put in the fuel we need for our flight today, because at the moment the aircraft has the tanks of the aircraft are filled completely with fuel, so they are 100% filled with fuel, but we do not need as much, we do not need 45.6 lbs, 1000 lbs for this flight today. We only need 21,500 lbs for this flight. So we go to FS Actions, I think. Yeah, that is fuel, and we can type in 21,500. This is the amount of fuel we will need for this flight today. So we can go back into the FMC to the performance init page, and now can type in the cost index. It's 45 for this flight. I always use 45, and our cruising altitude is flight level 360. We could climb to flight level 384 at maximum, but we will climb to flight level 360. So there's everything all right. We can press execute and now go to the N1 limit page. So due to the long runway here at San Diego and the weight of our aircraft today, we do not need normal takeoff. We can use takeoff one today, but we will need but we will do a normal climb. No descent path after goals. I don't know whether it's a problem, but yeah, let's clear this message. So then we go to the takeoff page. We will take off with using flaps 5. Here are our V speeds. We can put them in here, and also we can now calculate our center of gravity is 23.5, and here we can see our trim for takeoff, which we need to put in later on. So now our CDU pre-flight is completed, and we can go on with the pre-flight procedure. But before we do this, we need to close some entries on the left side. It looks like all passengers are boarded already, are on board. That's fine, that's great. We can also look out here. Yeah, the baggage is also loaded into the belly of the aircraft, so we can close the cargo doors too. So we need to go to the next page. There they are. There we can close them. So, and now we go on with the pre-flight procedure. So there we need to turn on the jaw damper. Maybe we can use a different view towards the overhead panel. So where's the jaw damper? Jaw damper switch. No, I don't find it. Where is it? Jaw damper. There it is. So there it is. Jaw damper 2 on. Then we can start the APU. And therefore we also need to turn on the left forward fuel pump. It's this one. Should be this one. So that the APU is also getting some fuel to run perfectly. And now we need to wait until the APU is started so that we then can use the APU generator to get electricity here on board. And afterwards we can disconnect the ground power and also the air conditioning unit. So, but until the APU is started completely, we can also already do some other things. We can close the emergency light switch guard so that the emergency lights are armed. We can turn on the seatbelt signs. We set them to auto. We can turn on the window heat here at the top on the left side and forward window heat, and on the right side the forward and side window heat too. So then we can disconnect the ground power now because the APU is running. We can turn on the APU generators and turn off the ground power at here and disconnect the ground power and also the air conditioning unit now. So we use this FMC to be here in the menu, FS actions, ground connections, ground power removed, air conditioning unit is also removed. So then we can go back into the other view to have a good view here towards the overhead panel, towards the lower overhead panel. So the next step is to set the left and right pack to auto. We have those switches here, both go to auto. Then we set in our flight altitude here. It's flight level 360. It was a little bit too much. There it is, flight level 360. We move the ignition switch to ignition right because we'll first start engine number 2 during pushback. So the engine on the right side. Then we set the auto brake to RTO and can also turn on the meter so that we also see our altitude here, not only in feet but also in meters. And we now push the traffic switch to see all the traffic later on when also the TCAS is activated. We move both VOR switches, this one to VOR1, this to VOR2, and also activate the flight director here on the left side and there on the right side on the first officer side. So great, we are finished with the pre-flight procedure and now we can do the pre-flight checklist. So pre-flight checklist, oxygen, we can test it now, it's tested 100%. Navigation, transfer and display switches are normal auto. Window heat is set to on, you can see the green lights here. The pressurization mode selector is at auto. Flight instruments, heading, we can set the runway heading in here. It should be something about 090. So let's type in 090 at here. And we can set the local altimeters. It's 2993. So the parking brake is set, but here it is not set. Here it says parking brake set, but here it is not set. So we set the parking brake now, so that's really set. And now we have a look at the engine start levers. They are at position cutoff. Perfect. We are finished with the pre-flight checklist and can go on with the before start procedure. There we first need to remove the pitot covers, which are here in the front of the aircraft. You see these red things here at the nose of the aircraft. These are the pitot covers. We need to remove them now. So we can do this also here. It's down here, pitot covers removed. Then the next step is to type in several things here in the multi-control panel in the MCP. First we need to activate to arm the auto thrust. Then we type in here at the speed, we type in V2. It's 147 knots. So there we have 147 knots. Then we can arm VNAV and LNAV. And the runway heading is already set. Then we also set the cruising altitude here. It's flight level 360. So there we have it. There it is. Flight level 360. And that's everything we need to put in here in the MCP. Now we can turn on all other fuel pumps. And the electric one and two hydraulic demand pumps can also go to on. These are this one here. Both go to on. The anti-collision light, so the beacon, is we can now turn on. So we're getting closer. You can see we're getting closer to the engine start now. And we will set the takeoff trim. We will need 5.13 for this takeoff. At the moment it's 4.0. So we need to move this wheel a little bit until it's at 5.13. Now we are around about 5. And now it should be, oh, it's too much now. Yeah, that looks good, I think. Yeah, 5.12, it's nearly 5.13. That doesn't matter, this little difference doesn't matter. So, and then we are complete with the B4 start procedure and can go on with the B4 start checklist, and afterwards we will start with our pushback and leave gate 26 here at San Diego Airport. So, B4 start checklist. Flight deck door is closed and locked. We can also have a look outside that we closed all doors. These are closed, cargo doors are closed, and here on the left side all doors are closed as well. You also see the red beacon here and at the top and at the bottom of the aircraft here. That's activated, the anti-collision light. So fuel, we have 21.5 lbs on board as requested, and the pumps, fuel pumps, are on. Passenger signs are set. Are on, windows are locked. The MCP V2-147, heading 090, altitude flight level 360 is set. Takeoff speeds are V1-137, VR-138, and V2-147. CDO preflight is completed, rudder and aileron trim is 3-0. Taxi and takeoff briefing, yeah. We can say we completed the taxi and takeoff briefing, and the anti-collision light is on. Perfect, before start checklist completed, we can now go on with the pushback. So we need to taxi in this direction, so the nose needs to be to the right side, and the nose needs to be to the right side and the tail to the left side. So let's open the menu of GSX again, and we can press here, prepare for pushback and departure, and nose right, tail, we select nose right, tail left. And we don't want to start our engines before pushback, we will do this during pushback. So there's the pushback truck, nice, great pushback truck today, and this one now will be connected to our nose gear by the ramp agent, by the marshaller. Great, we are also ready for pushback. That's perfect. So we first need to remove the wheel chocks. They're removed now. We can clear this master caution message. And now he will connect the aircraft, the nose gear of the aircraft, with the pushback truck, and then we can start our engines, and therefore we also need to turn off the packs. We can do this now, I would say. So here from the first officer seat, it's easier to see the switches of the we should release the parking brake now. Yeah, we can do this, release parking brake. So we have the clearance to start all engines, both packs are turned off, so we can start engine 2 first. So we move this switch to ground, to GRD, and as you can see, engine number 2 is starting, and at about 25% of N2 we can give fuel to the engine. So I would say we can now give some fuel to the engine and get back into the virtual cockpit here onto the captain's seat. So, and we have to wait until engine number 2 is stabilized so that we can then continue with starting engine number 1.